All right, so in this situation, we are spinning an object around with a rope in a circle. We're going to assume it's a horizontal circle. And we really know nothing about this object. We do not know its mass. We do not know its speed. We don't even know the length of the rope. All we know is that the tension in this rope is 80 newtons. And so then we change some things. We want to know the new tension. So this is a situation where if you know nothing, you can make it up. So we know that the tension is the force towards the center. And in this case, it's what's causing the centripetal force. And the centripetal force has the equation mv squared over r. And that, again, is equal to the tension force because we're assuming no other forces on this. So let's look at our before, and let's look at our after. So before, we say, what is the mass? We don't know, so let's make it up. 1 kilogram sounds good. We don't know the velocity, so let's make it up. 1 meter per second. We know the radius, let's make it up 1 meter. I choose all ones for this reason, because then when I go to find FC, I say 1 times 1 squared over 1 equals 1. Now we know that the tension force is not 1 before, we know it's 80, but we don't care, we're just trying to establish a baseline. So in the before situation, everything's 1, so the force ends up being 1. So then we say after, what has changed? So m, v, and r. So the mass is half, so the mass is 0.5 now. Its speed is doubled, so the speed is 2. And it doesn't say anything about the rope, so the rope is the same, it's 1. So in that case, the centripetal force now, mv squared, so 0.5 times v squared, 2 squared over 1. 0.5 times 4 is 2, so I end up with a centripetal force of 2. So if this represents 80 newtons, 1 to 2, that's doubling. So the new tension then is going to be twice that, or 160 newtons. So what we just did is we chose some nice easy numbers to work with and said, okay, it's twice what it was before, so the tension has doubled. That's really all we're doing. So let's do another example. So here we have a car going around a turn, and the turn is got a radius, so it's a curved road. Here's our car going around the turn. And the road has a radius, it's unknown. But again, what's going on here? We have friction is what's making this happen. The friction of the car, the friction of the road is pushing the car towards the center of the circle so it can make this turn. And we know nothing about it at all. So we've got the car and we've got the truck. So what do we know about the car? Let's say its mass is 1 kilogram. Let's say its velocity is 1 meter per second, and let's say its radius is 1 meter. Nice and easy, because then mv squared over r, the centripetal force, is 1 newton. Right? This is the frictional force, is what's pushing it towards the center, but that frictional force is equivalent to the centripetal force because it's the same. It's the only force acting inward. Now the truck, what's different about the truck? The truck has twice the mass, 2 kilograms. The velocity is twice, and the radius is half, 0.5. So mv squared over r, we've got 2 times 2 squared over 0.5. So 2 times 4 is 8 divided by 0.5. I get 16 newtons. So whatever force of friction the car needed, the truck needs 16 times the friction. So that better be a good road, because if it's not, the truck's going to not be able to make the turn. It's going to basically go off the road. But basically that's how we do these types of problems, where we're just looking at relationships and trying to determine the effects. So until next time, I am Derek Genova. Have a delightful day.